had to just make sure we weren't too early. Rick always, we made it, you know, the last minute, we were just on time. He says it's 6:50. Well, thank you all for coming. Welcome. I think this is kind of a Lutheran congregation. Maybe I should just say, why don't you all move up into this section? But I know there are people that like those back seats, right? Yeah. Well, thanks again. This is a special evening of rejoicing and singing. Many of you have grown up in an area where we've done a lot of singing, and so I know there are some good voices out there, so it should be a really good night of singing. We started this occasion in 2021. Rick died in February, and his birthday was March 24th. And we always asked, or I always asked, what he wanted to do on any birthday, and the thing that he always said was, let's just get some people together and sing. That's what he wanted to do, sing hymns and whatnot. So as you heard last year and again this year, that's what we just choose to do, sort of in honoring that. And I don't want to make it a memorial, but I do want to make it a time of rejoicing, because there is great life that he's enjoying at this point, and yet to get together and glorify God through music. So I wanted to share a little bit out of scripture, or that was Psalm 27, which was really a chapter that meant a lot to us. Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my stronghold, the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Those are the first two verses. And then down a little farther, it's one thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord and to seek him in his temple. And then the last verses of Psalm 27 are some scripture that was just the week before. Somebody had come out to visit us at the farm, and they said, there's been a verse that's just been really meaningful to me, and he talked about living in the land of the living. And he had read that verse to us when we were there, and he said, I can't remember exactly where it's located, though, so he said, I'll find that out. So texted us back and said it was Psalm 27. Actually, I take that back. He did not text it back. We were trying to figure out where it was. So the night before he died, we were listening to Psalms, which we often did, audio in the night or whenever we really wanted. And it was like, this is what he read. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And then the next verse is really became meaningful to me after all this happened. It's, wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart. And wait for the Lord. So those two verses there, I may remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And that morning, right after he died, that was one of the first verses that they read that morning on the radio station I was listening to. It was like, yeah, it was just a gift. You know, so again, he's enjoying life in the land of the living. We know that because he trusted, you know, the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And you can also have that. He celebrated his birthday on March 24th, and I just, he shared that with a niece, Melissa, and she just turned 40 this year, so they used to, when she was young, they would go to breakfast, and whatever. So I was wondering if Melissa and the girls would come up of the family. Now, I just found this out today. They each came through the line. It's like, you're wearing the same dress as your other sister. So why don't you four sisters come up? I know Kyle doesn't really want to be part of this, but we're going to all sing happy birthday to Melissa. Is that all right with you all? So come on up. So there's Kyle is the oldest, then Melissa, who shared the birthday with Rick. Annette, who is not here this evening, Krista, Kimberly, and then Janessa. So they'll come up. And why don't you just all stand before we start? We'll just sing happy birthday to the girls, and then or to Melissa. And then God's blessing for her, and then we'll begin, okay? And I'll go try to play. Okay.
start this evening, we're going to sing a chorus. And I think most of you probably know it by heart, but can you turn this down just a little bit?
Hold it closer, you didn't.
All right. It's a chorus, Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus. If you don't know that, it's on number 284 in the hymn book. Turn your eyes upon Jesus.
Gracious God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to gather here tonight with your people to celebrate Rick, to remember him, but also to say praises to you, Father. We thank you for giving us voices to respond in worship to you. I pray that you would be present here tonight, that every aspect of what we do would remind us of your love, your grace for undeserving sinners. That we would be pointed again toward the cross. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor. If you would turn, now we're going to give you opportunities again tonight. If you have a favorite that you want to sing, keep that in mind, because we're going to do some of that. But we're going to start out with number 3, Praise to the Lord the Almighty. If you would turn to that. Number 3, and you know, we're going to start out standing. Please stand.
Thank you.
370? For 370.
Sure, would you want to join us and sing? It's all familiar songs. I know you can you can operate it.
Sure.
We will take all the musicians and we'll go forward. And it seems like every time we gather together in this neighborhood and all this place we call Spruce Valley so lovingly, there's always a song that everybody likes to sing, and it's based on scripture out of Thessalonians. Then we who are alive remain shall be caught up together with him in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Someday soon we'll fly away. And I got to check with all the musicians. Are we in the key of D? No? Okay. B sharp? Okay.
Wait a minute. We're in D? Okay.
You know, it don't have to be D, just so it's close. Oh, sorry, I got that wrong.
Around the key of D?
Near that, yeah. Okay, 256, you know, what do we stand up? We're talking about meeting the Lord in the air. We can't be sitting sitting out. We got to sing.
Thank you.
us about, you know, eternal life coming. And just my one of my memories of Rick was shortly after, I think 2 days after Rick died, we were playing with Little Sinova, you know, and I said, it's just so sad that Rick can't experience more of this. And somebody said, they said he's probably thinking to himself, it's just too bad they can't experience where I am. That's gonna be even better. So let's turn over to 341. I know who holds tomorrow.
I just live.
one more song that would sum up all our hopes. And our hope, my hope right now is that we all play G, okay? No, sorry. F. F.
283. F.
What's better? Yeah, let's go with F.
Thank you.
not be new to most of you, Rick's favorite song was Great Is Thy Faithfulness.
Quite telling to me, and
Anyway, I remember that part, and then also I had an opportunity to visit Rick. Was it 2 years ago? I just showed up, didn't I? Mm-hmm. You were at
your... Yes, you did.
Yeah, I just showed there I was. And I felt like, and I was a little worried because I hadn't been there for a while as to where you live now, and I found it, no problem. So that was pretty amazing because I am directionally challenged by that. I'm from North Dakota, and everything's in a straight line there. You guys have lakes and girls and things like that. But one more. I know, I'm sorry, Sharon, I'm embarrassing you. But she started it, that song, I just had a blank, Power and Blood. I think Luke, Pastor Luke, you're here, right? Yeah, there you are. And Linda Palm. Did your teenage girls ever sing that song by standing up, Power and Blood, all the time? Back in the day, my children were the same age as some of the Larson girls and the Clupin girls, and they would sing all, stand up, sit all together, and when they were doing Power and Blood, they would stand up. And I was a little disappointed you had to stand up all the time. Because we could have stand up when we were there. I don't know if they ever remember that, but they would stand up, and I'm up there trying to... Okay, I'm done. Okay. But I appreciate Ron asking me to pray. We'll try. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we are so very thankful that we can come before you tonight and celebrate a wondrous spirit of Rick as he led us for so many years in this wonderful music that you inspired us to sing. Dear Lord, we pray that his memory would be carried on for years and years as the music is so precious to us, and we are so thankful that we can still come here and do this. And dear Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to honor not only Rick, but of course your son, Jesus Christ, for his the reason that we are here. Set us free, gave us peace with you, and now, dear Lord, we can sing about that and be thankful. And now, bless the rest of this evening. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
21.
Thank you. Well, there's a couple songs that whenever we were together, you know, we had to sing. And of course, one of them was, we called it John's song, Holy, Holy, Holy. And another one was, His Well With My Soul. I think we almost always close our practice. We sit down here and we practice, and then our closing song is usually that. And we'd come up here and we'd stand in a circle. So we were singing to each other. And it was really a special part of the evening. It was even better than the coffee. So it was an amazing time. And you know, we haven't sung now for a long time. We kind of lost our, you can't replace Rick. I know Wani's played for us a couple of times, but a couple of different occasions, but it's just not the same. I can't tell you how blessed I am to have had the friends that I've had, and you know why, you know, and you know, even though I'm still a young man, so that's a laugh. I've lost lots of good, close friends, and it always hurts. Can I share a little bit about when the morning Rick passed away? It's okay. I know I told this to Rick too, Wani's sister. And one of my other blessings was I got to work with Dana Hedlund for 5 years at the funeral home. And the vast majority of the time it was to help on the day of the funeral, carrying flowers and help get set up. Once in a while, you know, something else would come along that Dana asked if I could help with. And I mean, that was, to be around Dana, you know, has been a blessing to us. And a whole other story. But we were setting up for a funeral the morning that Rick passed away. And I was going up to the funeral home at 8:30 in the morning. And I'd gotten a text from Phil that morning and said that Rick had just passed away. I got up to Phil Sagas and I told Dana, Rick passed away. And he hadn't heard. So we just proceeded to the Catholic Church and we're getting things organized for this funeral. And we got everything carried in and more or less set up. And it was probably about, and now there's a time of visitation, but it was about an hour and a half before the service actually started, or maybe a little less than that. And Dana got a phone call and got the official word that Rick had passed away. And Dana came back to me and he said, we gotta go. And I said, right now? And he said, yeah, we gotta go. He called his wife and she, of course, came down and stayed at the church to make sure everything was running smoothly. And Dana and I took off. And Dana is this most incredible person. You know, he's calm and cool and collected. But when we were going out to Rick's house, I know he was going 90 miles an hour. And I was scared. I said, Rick, or I said, Dana, you gotta slow down here. And he said, we don't have much time. So, you know, he was finally down County Road 4, and we got to the gravel road, and he slowed down, and we just drove and drive him nice and slow. Walked in the house and got hugs from Juanita and family, and they said, have a seat. So we sat down by Rick's bed, and Rick was truly at peace. But we sat there around his bed and we started singing some songs. And it was the most amazing time. And we sang one song and then another, and then we prayed. And, you know, I think half an hour went by, and I said to Juanita, I said, Dan's not going to tell you this, but he's got a funeral. He's got to be up about half an hour. Oh, okay, okay. So anyway, we took Rick's body and made another quick trip into the town. And I won't go into all the details, but you know, just this so peaceful at Juanita's house. So scary and chaotic that drive out there to drive back into town. And we pulled up in front of the Catholic church. We walk in and Dana's this cool and calm as can be. You know, just hello, how are you? You know, greeting the family. You would have never known the stress that I saw him that hour before. And we got to the church about 20 minutes before the service, and Dana gathered the pallbearers, and I don't even remember whose funeral it was, but it was at the Catholic church. But what a blessing to be part of that. That was a special day. I know it's hard in many ways, but what a special day. And that I could be part of it, it's like, why me, Lord? You know, what a blessing. So anyway, I consider Rick one of my best friends. And we didn't spend tons of time, but there were times that it was so good to be with Rick. So anyway, thank you, Juanita. God bless you. Thanks for putting up with me here. Love you guys.
Yeah, thanks Dan for sharing. I know that was really putting you on the spot, but there were so many occasions like that where God just orchestrated the days, and it was one of those days that that was true. It was a morning that Carla was happy to be there, and we were, Ashley and Jenny had come up the night before because I said things were changing, and so then about 6, yeah, it was 6 o'clock or night before 6, about 6 I guess, that I said, I could tell it was getting closer, so Carla, I called her, and she ran up and got the kids, and they came down, and you know, we just sat together, and that Psalm 27, that, you know, that had come to me, that in the land of the living, you know, and we read that, and he took his last breath, you know, and so it was really sweet in that way, and thank you for, you know, part of that. But the men's course has been so much through the years, and I think of so many of the songs, and that's what has been so meaningful. And I was thinking that since it's request now, I would also like to request that maybe the Larson family, that we all got together, and maybe you could come up and sing with, and we can join the Larson family and cousins maybe that are here. I think it's, I'm trying to think of the song, but it's a Guy Meal.
Like a river?
Yes. Why don't you come up with that and play, and then let's sing that. I'm not sure where it is, but Like a River Glorious, it's in. But this is a song that many times when the Larsons and Cookins are together, this is what the song. Cheryl, why don't you come on up too and sing.
Why don't we all sing the first verse and then the cousins and whatever.
Benton County, Sarah Juanita and I, and Rick sang a group called the Mill City Singers out of Minnetonka Community Church. And we did that for a number of years. And we always practiced at Joni and Doug Kraft's house. Joni and Doug went to the church there too. We had such a great time. The reason why I'm saying this is because every time we have a hymn singer like this, Joni and Doug are asking when it's going to be, and they listen to the when it's placed on Facebook. It's still very special to them. And there was 8 of us in the group, I believe, and we sang in different places. We did sing here at Elam once, too. So I just want to give a shout-out to Joni and Doug, who will be hearing this once it's posted on Facebook. Great friends. And they now live in Seattle. And the one thing that we always kind of laughed about was, and Joni, you'll probably hear this for your first time, but Joni would serve cake when we had practice. And Joni's pieces of cake were like none ever known to us. It kind of felt like we were all eating a fourth of the cake or half of the cake. And they were big pieces and they were wonderful, they were huge. They were wonderful pieces of cake, and Rick and Juanita and I will never forget that. We refer to now as Joni pieces of cake. People big pieces of cake, it's Joni pieces of cake. So, Joni and Doug, we love you. Thank you for the memories.
You have some sheets of paper. If you want to put them right there. Does anybody not have? That should be somewhere. Okay. Singing I Go is one that it's been a while since I have sung this, and I came across it in another hymnal. And I would love to sing that one. So we're going to give that a try. I'm sure quite a few of you have sung this. But I have not sung this. So I might just ask Cody if you just play through it once.
Thank you.
Jesus forever. Is there another choice?
61.
61?
61.
61. And Genesee, number 61. This is a good song to sing parts on. Okay, stand up.
Thank you.
246.
Thank you. good collage of choruses to end with. I can't think of a better bunch to head on their way. I'm going to share just a little bit about Rescue, but I'll be little. Not going to be long at all. And like you, Rick, I need to call you. Now you can send me a kid. I'm not going to be that long. I'm not going to be that long. But at any rate, I would just want to say that if I were to characterize this last month, it would have been under two words, contented anticipation. And I would trust that as we go on in life, that might be our character as well. Contented anticipation. And because of Jesus, that can be true. Let's bow. Our Heavenly Father, at this time of the year, it's such a joy to look back at the cross and recognize those wonderful, wonderful words, "It is finished." And thank you that it was finished for us, finished before the Father. And thank you that because of that, we can live in contented anticipation with great confidence. And we would praise you now for those who have lived, and thank you for them. Thank you for the memories. Thank you for the legacy, even more than the memories. And we would ask that as we go through life, we would be simply living for you. Remembering that to live for Jesus is what really matters. Thank you that we can look back on our life where that was true. And now as we go forth tonight, thank you for these choruses. Thank you that burdens are lifted at Calvary. We thank you that because of that, you enable us to love you. Thank you that we anticipate that wonderful day when we'll look upon his face and then never need to cease singing and recognizing he is Lord. And in that strength, we pray that we would go forth in your presence for your glory until we return. In Jesus' name, amen.